Welcome to a lesson on symmetry about the x-axis, y-axis, and the origin. The goals of the video are to define the different types of symmetry, and then also to determine if the graph of a given equation would be symmetrical about the x-axis, y-axis, and the origin. Let's start by discussing symmetry about the x-axis. The graph of an equation is symmetrical about the x-axis if whenever x comma y is on the graph, so is x comma negative y. So for example, looking at this graph, if we selected this point here and labeled it x comma y, notice how this graph would also contain the point down here, which would have coordinates x comma negative y. And this would be true for any two points on this graph because it has x-axis symmetry. There's also a way to verify x-axis symmetry visually. If we fold this graph across the x-axis, or across this horizontal line, notice how the top half and the bottom half would match up perfectly. If we fold this graph down across the x-axis, notice how the top would match up perfectly with the bottom. And there's also a way to verify x-axis symmetry algebraically. The graph of an equation will have symmetry about the x-axis if we get an equivalent equation when y is replaced with negative y. So for example, this graph has an equation x equals y squared. We replace y with negative y, we'd have the equation x equals negative y squared. And since a negative times a negative is positive, while raising a negative to an even power is always positive, this would simplify to x equals y squared, which is equivalent to the original equation, which verifies the graph would have x-axis symmetry. Now let's talk about y-axis symmetry. The graph of an equation is symmetrical about the y-axis if whenever the point x, y is on the graph, then so is the point negative x comma y. So again, for example, if we label this point here with coordinates x comma y, notice how this graph would also contain the point on the left with coordinates negative x comma y. And again, this would be true for any two points on this graph because it does have y-axis symmetry. Visually, if we fold this graph across the y-axis, or this vertical line here, one half of the graph would match up perfectly with the other half. For example, if you folded this to the left in this direction, notice how the right side would match up perfectly with the left side. Again, visually verifying we have y-axis symmetry. And then algebraically, the graph of an equation will have symmetry about the y-axis if we get an equivalent equation when replacing x with negative x. So the equation of this graph is y equals x squared. If we replace x with negative x, we would have the equation y equals negative x squared. But again, negative x squared is equal to x squared, so we have y equals x squared, which is equivalent to the original equation, algebraically verifying this equation would have y-axis symmetry. Now the last type of symmetry we want to discuss in this video is symmetry about the origin. And the graph of an equation is symmetrical about the origin if whenever the point x comma y is on the graph, then so is the point negative x comma negative y. So looking at the provided graph, if we labeled this point here with coordinates x comma y, notice how this graph would also contain this point here, which would have the coordinates negative x comma negative y. And again, this would be true for any two points on this graph because it has symmetry about the origin. Now the visual test for symmetry about the origin is a little bit trickier. It's often called the rotational test, which means we're going to rotate this graph about the origin or this point here. And if we can rotate this graph anything less than one complete turn, and it would look exactly the same, it would have symmetry about the origin. So for example, if we rotated this graph one half turn about the origin, or 180 degrees, meaning we rotated it from here to here about the origin, notice how it would look exactly the same because the piece in the first quadrant would be moved to the piece in the third quadrant, and then the piece in the third quadrant would be up in the first quadrant, and the graph would look exactly the same. So this is the visual test for symmetry about the origin. Algebraically, The graph of an equation will have symmetry about the origin if we get an equivalent equation when x is replaced with negative x and y is replaced with negative y. So the equation of this graph is y equals 1 divided by x. So now to check for symmetry about the origin, we're going to replace y with negative y and x with negative x. When we do this, at first, it won't look the same. We'd have negative y equals 1 divided by negative x. Again, it doesn't look the same, but it is equivalent. Remember, we can multiply both sides of an equation by a constant. If we multiplied both sides of the equation by negative 1, this would just change the sign of these two terms. We would have y equals 1 divided by positive x, which is equivalent to the original equation. So again, these two equations here are equivalent. And we replaced x with negative x and y with negative y. Therefore, we have symmetry about the origin. We're going to go ahead and stop here for this video. There is a link on the screen to more examples of given an equation determining what types of symmetry the graph would have. Now there's one more thing I do want to mention though. Most graphs do not have symmetry about the x-axis, y-axis, or the origin. So keep in mind the examples that we're looking at are special cases. Okay, I hope you found this introductory video helpful.